The word peer refers to experts within a specific discipline: nursing, history, speech-language pathology, engineering, biology, and so on. So if you work in the field of chemistry, other chemists are your peers. When a chemist conducts an experiment, then writes up his results for a chemistry journal, he then sends the manuscript of his article to a journal. In this case, he might send his article to the Journal of Organic Chemistry. The editor of the journal will look at the article and make sure the topic of the article is right for the journal. Then the editor will send the chemist manuscript to three other experts in chemistry. These experts will read the manuscript and give feedback to the editor. Sometimes the peer experts will say that the article is good and should be published. Sometimes the peer experts will reject the article and say that the research was not done well. Or sometimes the peer experts will say the article is good, but needs some revision. If the article was not rejected, it will then be published in the Journal of Organic Chemistry. The process of having experts within a field review someone's research write-up before it is published is the peer review process. Journals that require manuscripts to be reviewed before being selected for publication are more credible, reliable, and of more quality than periodicals that do not require peer review. This is why scholars and students often like to use peer-reviewed journals for research, because they know that the information was reviewed before it was published. Peer review is known by two other terms: refereed and juried. When you see the term refereed, think of referees that throw penalty flags in football games, or who determine whether a football play is good or bad. In the scholarly world, referees read articles and determine whether the articles are good or bad, and thus, whether or not the article should be published. With the word juried, think of a judge and jury listening to a court case. In the scholarly world, a jury or several judges will determine whether an article is good or bad and whether it should be published or not. The best kind of peer review process is called a double-blind peer review. This is where the author's name is stripped off of the manuscript before the reviewers read it, and the authors never know the names of the reviewers. This allows for the least amount of bias. Just a quick word of caution before we end. Peer review helps readers, that's you, identify good articles for sources of information. However, just because an article has gone through the peer review process, there is no absolute guarantee that the research is good. So that means you always have to read articles with a critical eye, so you yourself can determine whether the research is good.